मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर भारती पाटील, वर्किंग ॲज ॲन असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर फिजिक्स इन महाराजा जिवाजीराव शिंदे कॉलेज श्रीगोंदा अहमदनगर. लास्ट टाइम वी हॅव सीन वॉट इज क्रिश्चॉफ लॉ, क्रिश्चॉफ्स करंट लॉ अँड क्रिश्चॉफ्स व्होल्टेज लॉ. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द व्होल्टेज अँड करंट डिवायडर सर्किट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्होल्टेज डिवायडर सर्किट्स. In order to understand voltage divider circuit, we will see what is a series circuit. A series circuit is a one in which all the components are connected end to end so that all the current will follow or flow through each and every component of the circuit. And such type of circuit is called as series circuit. What is series circuit? Series circuit is a circuit in which all the components of the circuit are connected end to end so that all the current in the circuit can flow through each component. And such type of one series circuit is shown here. In this we have used battery across a series combination of resistance, three resistance R1, R2 and R3. All these three resistors are connected end to end and across them a battery supply, battery is attached. The same circuit can be shown by this figure. That is, here battery is shown and all these three resistors, that is R1, R2 and R3, they are in series. And such circuit is called as series circuit. In case of series circuit, now we will see the properties of series circuit. In series circuit, as shown in figure, in series circuit which is shown in figure, first property is that the same current will flow through three resistors R1, R2 and R3. That is, current flowing through all resistance which are in series is same. Means, if I amount of current is flowing through the circuit, then same I amount of current will flow through R1, R2 and R3. Then second property is that the voltage drop across R1, voltage drop across R2 and voltage drop across R3 voltage drop across R1 will be given by I into voltage drop across R1 will be given by V1 is equal to I into R1. Then voltage drop across R2, resistor R2 will be given by V2, and it is nothing but I into R2, because amount of current flowing through the circuit is same. And voltage drop across the resistor, third resistor R3, that is V3, is equal to I into R3. Then this voltage drop, the value of voltage, total voltage drop will be equal to, that is V1 plus V2 plus V3, or IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3 should be equal to applied voltage, that is capital V. And third property is that the total resistance of the circuit is given by total resistance. Total resistance of the series circuit is given by sum of all the resistances present in series, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3. These are the three properties of series circuit. Let's revise them. We have started with series circuit. Series circuit is formed by end-to-end connection of all the components as shown in figure. This figure represents one of the series circuit. It can also be represented by that manner. Then the properties of series circuit is that, first one is the current flowing through all the resistances which are in series is same. Suppose I amount of current is flowing through R1, R2 and R3. It means that current flowing through R1, R2 and R3 will remain same, that is I. Voltage drop across R1, R2, R3. If we observe here the values of voltage drop across R1, R2 and R3, as I is constant and here capital V is also constant, and this I or voltage drop across R1, R2, R3 is directly proportional to the values of resistances. The values of resistances matters a lot in case of series circuit, in case of voltage drop. It means that voltage drop is directly proportional to the value of resistances. If resistance increases, then voltage drop across the circuit will also increase. Then this voltage drop is shown by a formula. V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2, and V3 is equal to I into R3. And the third property is that all the sum of all the voltages, that is V1 plus V2, voltage drop, these are the voltage drop, voltage drop across R1, R2, R3 will equals to applied voltage, that is 12 volt. Then third property is that the total resistance of the circuit is given by addition of R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now we will find the values of V1, V2 and V3 in case of this series circuit. In order to find the value of resistance, just now we have seen in this third property, that is resistance, total resistance of series circuit is nothing but R is equal to sum of R1 plus R2 plus R3. R1 plus R2 plus R3. That is R1 value is 1K, 1 kilo ohm. R2 value is 2 kilo ohm. R3 value is 3 kilo ohm. It means that value of R equals to 3, 2, 1. It means that 6 kilo ohm. 6K will be the total resistance of this circuit. Now we have to calculate V1, V2 and V3. In order to calculate that voltage drop, V1, V2 and V3, we know that here value of I is not known. but one can calculate the value of I, because we know that by Ohm's law V is equal to IR. Suppose V is the voltage, this voltage, and R is the total resistance that I have calculated here. Now the circuit current can be calculated from this formula. Total current is equal to V, that is applied voltage, divided by total resistance. Applied voltage divided by total resistance. So I is equal to V upon R. That value you have to substitute here, and it will remain same in all the cases. It means that here replace I by V by R into R1. This will be the value of V1. Now what will be the value of V2? Value of V2 is equal to replace I by capital V upon capital R into R2, and here V by R into R3. Now substitute the value of V and R. What is the value of V and R? So V1, that is voltage drop across R1, is equal to V. V means applied voltage, it is 12 volt, divided by R. R means total resistance of the circuit. Just now we have calculated, it is the sum of all the resistances, 6. It means that its value come out as 2, its value is 2 volt. Then next, V2 is nothing but voltage drop across the resistance R2, and its value can be found out by substituting the value into here V upon R. We have substituted, we should multiply it with R1, that is here luckily R1 value is 1, so 6 ones are 6, 6. Now in case of V2, we have to substitute the values of V and R, that is by substituting values of V and R. V value is 12, that is total voltage, and resistance, total resistance is 6, into the value of R2. R2 is given as 2K, it means that 2, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, and it comes out as 4 volt. Now we have to calculate the voltage drop across the resistance R3, and it can be found out by substituting the values of total resistance and the total voltage into 3K, that is the resistance R3, and its value is 6 volt. That is voltage drop across R1, R2, R3 are found to be 2 volt, 4 volt and 6 volt. Now our last statement, what was that statement? The sum of the voltages, one of the property, sum of the voltages across these resistances is equal to applied voltage. That is 12 volt should be equal to 2 volt plus 4 volt plus 6 volt. 6 plus 4, 10, and plus 2, 12. 12 volt. That is voltages across all the resistances is equal to applied voltage in case of series circuit. Now we will see the series divider circuit. By knowing series circuit, we will see series divider circuit. Series voltage divider circuit. This series voltage divider circuit consists of one or more resistances, two or more resistances, which are connected in series across a voltage source V, as shown in figure. Series voltage divider circuit consists of two or more resistances which are connected in series across a common voltage source V. Now, as we know that V current flowing through the series circuit, that is, suppose I is the current flowing through this circuit, then current flowing through R1 and R2 will remain same as I, total current. And we know that just now we have calculated for series circuit, that is, total resistance is equal to R1 plus R2. That is, R1 value is given here as 15 ohm plus R2 value is given as 5 ohm. It means that total resistance of the circuit is 20 ohm. This voltage 10 volt. 10 volt battery is attached here. Now here point A is showing the potential of 10 volt. And point C is showing the potential of 0 volt. It means that across this, the potential applied is 10 volt. Now, we will find the voltage drop across R1 and voltage drop across R2 in the similar way. R1 we have to find and voltage drop across R2 we have to find. If we observe here, applied voltage is 10 volt. Now because of the presence of R1 and R2, there will be voltage drop across R1 and voltage drop across R2. And this value will be less than applied voltage 10 volt. It means that this, because of presence of R1 and R2, this voltage will get divided. And hence, this is called as series voltage divider circuit. Now, we will see how the presence of R1 and R2 will divide the total voltage V. And because of this, this value is having value 10 volt, and the voltage drop across this and voltage drop across R2 is going to be less than 10 volt. It means that only one voltage is given, and because of R1 and R2, it is going to split into three. It means that three different voltages will be available for us. One is the applied voltage 10 volt, and one is the voltage across R1 and across R2. And if a circuit or load requires a voltage which is less than 10 volt, then one can use such type of voltage divider circuit so that one can use lesser voltages. Now, how to calculate voltage drop across R1? As we know that voltage drop across R1 is nothing but current into R1. And voltage drop across R2 is given by V2 is equal to total current into R2. And we have seen that I is nothing but V is equal to IR. And hence, I is equal to V upon R. That is, applied voltage divided by total resistance. So, substitute here V upon R into R1, here also V upon R into R2. By substituting values, V1 comes out as V1 is equal to V. What is the value of V here? Here it was 12. Here it is 10 volt. 10 volt divided by R. Value of R. R here not R1 or R2. Here value of R is the total resistance 20 ohm into value of R1. While calculating V1, we have to substitute the value of R1. Value of R1 is given as 15. So, here it comes out as 7.5 volt. That is, voltage drop across R1 comes out as 7.5 volt. Then next, substituting the values of V and R and R2, one can find out V2. So, in case of V2, value of V is the same, that is 10 volt, value of R is also same, that is 20, but value of R2 is different. And substituting value of R2, that is 5, we will get its value as 2.5 volt. It means that voltage drop across the resistance R2 is 2.5 volt. It means that this circuit, presence of R1 and R2, has divided this voltage into 7.5 volt and 2.5 volt. And we know that the sum of voltage drop across R1 and voltage drop across R2 is equal to 10 volt. If we add 7.5 volt plus 2.5 volt, then it gives us 10 volt. And this is due to the series arrangement of this R1, R2. So, here we have obtained the voltage across point A and C as 10 volt, voltage across A and B as 7.5 volt, and voltage across B and C as 2.5 volt. Thank you.